Are you an entrepreneur or looking to become one? Looking to stay motivated, find happiness and true success? You're in the right place. Welcome to Empower Humans.
Welcome to episode 33 of the Empower Humans podcast. I am flattered and grateful always for you sharing time with me on these podcasts. And this time I'm excited to talk about the subconscious mind and the power of belief. This topic is so important. We could probably do at least 20 episodes if we're being honest here about this. And maybe we will over time. I have been reading a book called The Power of Your Subconscious Mind by Dr. Joseph Murphy. And that came out in the 60s and has had some real staying power in this whole arena, this whole space of self-help and self-betterment and our thought processes and the law of attraction. That's a very long title for this space. But in any event, I have learned a lot recently about the ramifications of belief and the importance of consistency. And I want to remind you before we dig any deeper here that you are priceless. Nothing in this world or anything that has ever happened to any of us can overpower that inherent fact of existence. You are irreplaceable and bring important, positive, priceless value to this world. You are worth more than all your pains and sorrows and any material possessions this world has to offer. You are above that. And I remind you also that you are never alone. I am here for you, and I want to encourage you to continue to put one foot in front of the other. Whatever trials or turmoil you may be experiencing, you are not alone. Contact us, empowerhumans.com, empower101 on Instagram and Twitter. Happy to show support, answer questions, communicate, engage with our audience. You are not alone, and even if you're experiencing any of these sorts of trials and turmoil that all of us go through, that's one more reason you're not alone, because you're not the only one going through things. That might not be any source of solace, but we all have struggles, turmoil. I want you to keep your head up, stay strong. Let's talk about all of that in light of this topic today, because it actually kind of all ties together regarding our subconscious mind and our beliefs. In the book, The Power of Your Subconscious Mind, Dr. Joseph Murphy said, quote, "Every thought is a cause and every condition an effect," end quote. Every thought is a cause and every condition an effect. So thought is where it starts, and thoughts are where we form beliefs, okay? And we're going to talk a little bit later, as I always do lately, about the roots of words and these words, beliefs, expectations, and so on and so forth. Les Brown also said, quote, "How people live their lives is the result of the story they believe about themselves," end quote. So let's think about that as well, the story we tell ourselves. And it's, I love the word story, because it kind of implies that it's something that we're just telling, like a story, like a tall tale kind of thing, perhaps it might be, or hopefully it's more in line with the truth, which is your immense power and priceless worth. Speaking of beliefs and our subconscious mind, take note of this. Your imagination is a preview of what's to come. And when it comes to having a dream, what matters is our mindset. What do you think about the nature of the word dream? It's something literally that begins in a subconscious state. When you're sleeping and have dreams, literal dreams, they begin in the subconscious mind, and you can and should believe your dreams even in the more conscious state, the dreams of the goals and achievements that you'd like to attain to in your life, even when there's no evidence in the world around you to support them or the world around me. Okay, we need to believe in the good things. I'm going to say this again, and I hope it sinks in deeper. Something I've said in previous episodes, which is that anyone who has done anything great in this world, or that anything, any sort of legacy that we look at as some sort of greatness or that we can remember, has had to pay a price of turmoil and work and failure and heartache. You have to become obsessed. Like we talked a few times recently, I think in episode 10 of the podcast, your obsession becomes your possession. You have to become obsessed and work for your dream with belief. Did you know that Walt Disney filed bankruptcy and had two nervous breakdowns? Is he a crazy man? By many people's standards, maybe he was. I would submit that he was obsessed and, quote, crazy about accomplishing this dream he had and making the impact and legacy in the world that he largely did accomplish ultimately, even after all those many setbacks. So what do we believe about ourselves? What is the story that we're telling ourselves? What is the story that you are telling yourself? Okay, I pause for a second. Think about that, because I want us to get real here for a second. What is the story you are telling yourself? Now, if you're in business What is the story as to why you haven't expanded the business or made enough sales or whatever the case might be, hired the right employees? There's all kinds of things in business and whatever your faucet of business and entrepreneurship. What is the story we're telling ourselves? Because there's some set of sometimes limiting beliefs and stories that exist there. And that also can apply, as we always say, all these kind of principles that I share on this podcast generally apply in multiple key areas of life, family situations and other relationships and so on and so on and so on. So our physical bodies as well. What is our belief system there? So what is the story you tell yourself? Tony Robbins says that we have to be consistent about the story we tell ourselves. Beliefs that we embrace about ourselves and the path that we're on, in other words, we have to be consistent. And you might have to believe in somebody else's belief in you as you get your own belief to kick in for yourself. Now, I've referenced before that Rob Dyrdek said that belief is the only thing that matters. Obviously, there are more parts to the equation of making things happen, but the fuel and fire that actually brings things to fruition, to manifest in our lives, good or bad, mind you, is belief. What you believe is the most important thing behind all your actions and all the things that exist in your life. What exists around you in large measure is a byproduct of your belief patterns. Now, keep in mind, as we've alluded to here, actions back up belief. So belief is the starting line and the path to those dreams that we talked about. It's kind of the pavement of the path. Belief and our subconscious mind pave that path forward for us. I heard a story of a woman in this book, The Power of Your Subconscious Mind. It was Christmas Eve and she was at the mall. How many of you shop last minute for presents? Be honest here, and whether you celebrate Christmas or not, she was clearly procrastinating, and that's not the point of the story. She saw what she considered to be the most beautiful handbag, and she looked at that, and she caught herself in the former bad habit, about to tell herself, I can't afford that. How can I afford that? I can't have that. She remembered learning to believe, you know, not long before this, and tell herself reaffirming statements. She accepted deeply in her mind that that bag was hers with a gratitude, a deep gratitude that it was hers. Later that same night, her fiancé, who, by the way, wasn't with her at the earlier shopping experience, mind you, gave her a present, which, guess what, turned out to be the exact bag that she had seen, the exact style, and that she had told herself was hers earlier that same day. Was that a coincidence? I don't think so. There's all kinds of stories like this. Search online. There's videos and stories galore. And these stories are real and true. She believed it. She expressed gratitude. What do we learn from that? Let's apply those sorts of things of the belief and the gratitude and just expect to win. Expect to get the things, the situations, circumstances, feelings that you want in your life. You may not be there at this moment. Life is a constant. We don't plateau and get to a place where we've finally arrived in this world, in this life. So yes, we can balance. Yes, we can relax sometimes. But we can always progress. But on our path there, expect to win. Expect to get to the places you want to be, the milestones along your path. We have to stop using words like can't. I can't do that. I can't afford that. I can't be that. Just saying those phrases to you right now, myself personally, hurts my heart because that's not where my mind is. I've been there. I've done that. I still fall into that sometimes. Oh, I can't do that. And I'm trying to relate to the kind of the lowest common denominator here. I know we all get lost in those traps sometimes. The subconscious mind, which controls our heartbeat and our circulation and the digestion of food beneath the surface, that we kind of take for granted that, oh, our heart's just always going to be beating. And if we eat some food, it's going to be digested. It's a power, this subconscious mind, that keeps us alive and that can increase the power of that life if we tap into it, okay? By most people's standards, the subconscious mind controls constant miracles like converting food into energy and life-sustaining sustenance for our bodies and digestion, or it becomes tissue and other cells in our bodies. It is the miracle of transformation, and the subconscious mind controls it. Think about that. You eat something and it transforms into part of your body and your energy and so on and so on. It's life. Your subconscious mind controls all those processes in your body. Now, have you ever heard of a man named George Lucas? I bet most of you have heard of him. He's the creator and producer of a little movie franchise called Star Wars. When he created Star Wars, nobody knew how he was going to create these special effects. This was 1977 when it was released, at least. These movies, he didn't quite know how he was going to go about doing that. nothing like that had been done before. He had to invent whole new systems for the special effects and actually started a separate company called Industrial Light and Magic. Do you think he believed in what he was doing? He went out and created something and started another company against all the other thought processes surrounding special effects at the time. Now, many movie productions come to him nowadays and in the time since then for Industrial Light and Magic still, more than 40 years later, to help with their special effects on those productions. He paved a path on belief, not to mention becoming a billionaire in the process. I'm not saying any of us need to do something like that, but what is your path? What is the pavement that your subconscious mind can help create for you? And what are the belief patterns that we need to incorporate into that process? So I ask you, what are the possibilities? What are your fears? Okay, we have to weed out things that hold us back. I love this garden analogy. I've talked a little bit about it before. There's an article on our website that talks a little bit about this. And in a garden, we have to constantly cultivate and nurture and weed the garden for the beautiful fruits and flowers, so to speak, that we want to manifest in our lives. That's all symbolic. Weed out, my friends. Weed those things out. Weed your garden. And that doesn't mean necessarily go smoke weed. Clear out the weeds that are holding you back. Whether or not you smoke weed is not my topic right now. And just weed the garden of your mind to purify your beliefs so they become consistent, okay? Consistent beliefs. If you believe what I told you, that I say at the beginning of these podcast episodes, that you are priceless and you're never alone, if you don't believe that yet, believe it. Allow it to sink in. Sit back, close your eyes, breathe. The universe will manifest the truth of that into your heart, mind, and soul. I promise that is a fact, okay? Believe in yourself, believe in your priceless inherent worth, and believe that you're not alone. You have value, okay? You have priceless value. Now, here are a few phrases that stuck with me from the book that I ask us to kind of contemplate and ponder and maybe apply in our day-to-day world. So in the book, he said things like, your subconscious mind controls all the vital processes of your body and knows all your problems. He also said, whatever you impress upon your subconscious mind is expressed on the screen of space as conditions, experiences, and events. Therefore, you should watch all the ideas and thoughts that we entertain in the conscious mind. He also said, keep your conscious mind busy expecting the best, and your subconscious mind will faithfully reproduce your habitual thinking. Imagine the happy ending or solution to your problem, he also said. Feel the thrill of accomplishment, and what you imagine and feel will be accepted in your subconscious mind and bring it to pass. Now, this concept of belief or even faith has been around for a very long time. We read, all things are possible to him who believeth. Do these sorts of words and ideas written and expressed millennia ago apply to us now? These writings and ideas seem to have kind of withstood the test of time. Regardless of anyone's spiritual or religious belief systems, faith is a precursor of success. Belief is the indispensable ingredient in obtaining one's goals. Now, I want to talk a little about auto-suggestion and healing. Now, auto-suggestion basically means that if you imagine something as being possible, it comes true or can come to life. There are so many well-documented stories to support this. This applies for both things we want and don't want. That's why I always say we have to be very careful because, as we learn from Spider-Man, with great power comes great responsibility. And if we're really empowering ourselves and the world around us with this empower humans thing, we're giving ourselves increased power by definition, the word empower. Okay, so we have to be careful and responsible with what we do with this. There's a story of a man named Sam Schumann who was diagnosed with end-stage liver cancer, and he was only given a few months to live. He died just as expected during that time, but in the post-mortem autopsy report, we learned that they were wrong in their diagnosis. Okay, his tumor was small and it hadn't spread at all. He did not die of cancer. He died of his expectation that he would die of cancer. Think about that and let that sink in for a second. He did not die of cancer. He died of his expectation that he would die of cancer. Now, as you may have gathered by now, if you listen to this podcast regularly, I like to dig into the roots of words. We're going to talk more about some things that we can do to apply this in physical and mental and emotional and manifestation areas of our lives to get the things we want. But when we talk about the roots of these words, now we talked about this man expected the expectation that he would die of cancer. The word expectation comes from Latin roots meaning an awaiting. An awaiting. Okay, basically waiting for something. Just, I expect this. This is my expectation. I'm waiting for this. Belief is very similar and refers to a firm persuasion like faith. Faith can also mean loyalty. Okay, but basically we're waiting for something. This is what belief and expectation means. We have a firm persuasion of its truthfulness and its manifestation in our lives. So what are we focusing on? What are we believing? Like I said at the beginning, this is a very expansive topic, a very large and far-reaching topic. I want you to dig deeper in yourself and in the content available on this topic to really learn how to apply to your greatest benefit for all those things that matter most in your life. Okay, dig in and learn more about this and apply more because it is so powerful. It's at the roots, I would say, of getting what you want out of your life. In your relationships, in your business, in everything, okay? Let's focus on our beliefs and thought patterns, and I want to share a few principles to apply kind of individually here. If you have a problem of any sort, we must change the beliefs that may have caused it originally. And think about that, whether you have a marital situation or financial situation, a lot of times, a massive percentage, if not all of it, is tied to the beliefs of the people involved, okay? Some of this can apply to physical health, and like I say, wealth or money situations as well. People's beliefs and expectations are far more powerful, and I dare say even the main ingredient in what our lives turn out to be. Focus on your intentions and visualize, you know, the visualization of your dreams and desires. Be mindful. It's so important to focus mentally, and it may exhaust you, but that might be how you know you did it right. If you really focus mentally and really learn to tap in. You may not have ever done it really completely in your life, but you can dig in, and there's ways to learn how to do that through all kinds of things I'm about to talk about here. It's so important to focus mentally and believe in the outcomes that you want. See yourself in that situation with the job or the relationship or the vehicle or house or other thing, even a skinnier body, a more in shape body, whatever that might be. Feel it and believe it. Believe it, my friends. Believe it. I can't say that enough. Belief is so important, and I've seen it play out in my own life for better or worse, in good and bad ways, to be honest with you. And obviously, I'm focusing far more, you know, I'm paying attention to the good things with hope and positivity. It's very important to take advantage of your time just before you go to bed also. Whenever that might be for you, whether you work graveyards or whatever the case might be, but before you go to sleep, sleep time is a gift. So don't do what so many of us people do and have done, which is go to sleep thinking about what's wrong in our life or what we're sad or angry about, whatever these kind of negative feelings and emotions and concerns might be. You have to frame opportunities and access the unconscious, subconscious mind before you go to sleep to open that portal, so to speak, and get your mind, your subconscious mind, working with the powers around us to get these things to the right place, the place that you want in your life. You can have profound changes there. Practice taking time to breathe properly. You may only need 2 to 3 minutes, and everyone can find 2 to 3 minutes to do this. I promise you, everyone can. I guarantee it. And you can obviously go longer and even incorporate that with guided meditation. I've done some of that. These are available on YouTube and other places. Guided meditations for anywhere from a few minutes to hours if you really wanted to. And you can even go to sleep with some of these things in the background that just encourage and implant ideas and thoughts in your subconscious mind while you sleep. So there's all kinds of things. Find what works for you. If you imagine yourself in the place or with the thing that you desire, see it vividly with the colors and smells and feelings amplified to the highest degree you can muster in your mind. Seeing yourself there will only amplify the necessary belief to manifest these things. See, these things feed into each other. So see yourself there, amplify it, amplify it. Okay, just like turning up. I used to play guitar. Turn up the guitar amp. Turn up whatever the case might be. Amplify. That's what the word amplify means. Turn it up. Don't leave it quiet. Oh, I'm scared of that. I can't want that thing. Turn it up. Okay? Don't you think George Lucas set his mind on this end result with Star Wars, believed in that, and it helped guide his path to get the end result, and in the process build Industrial Light and Magic, and it heavily influenced the entire filmmaking industry for the next couple of generations. And on, he followed the 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, in particular Habit 2, which is begin with the end in mind. The biggest part of that habit and of obtaining anything is belief. If you are priceless, like we say here, and you are never alone, you are certainly worthy, and I beg you to believe in that power and worth right now if you haven't yet. It's up to you. I can't force that on you. You have to believe it. You just have to choose to believe it. And why wouldn't you? If you want things in your life, if the things are amiss that you need to get straightened out or fixed financially or whatever the case might be, why not believe in yourself? Tell yourself good things. Do what you need to do. Get obsessed with getting where you need to be. Don't ever believe anything to the contrary either about your priceless inherent worth. There are tons of techniques and resources to increase your power of belief and depth of engagement in your subconscious mind. I know this stuff is true and can really benefit you. Even though that rhymed, it's still true, and maybe it is even more true because it rhymed, like we learned in the Lego movie. Back to this in all seriousness, be careful what you focus on, but you can have everything you want, and it may just take a couple of small shifts in the pattern of thinking as we've laid out in this podcast. Okay, contact me, ask questions and so on, and we can talk more about this and engage about this particular topic. I want to challenge you again, study. Start studying if you haven't been. It's okay. Start now. No time like the present. And keep studying if you already have been. I'm on my 46th book. I've challenged myself to go through about a book a week. I'm ahead of myself now. So I'm happy about that. And I'm not trying to brag or anything like that. I just finished a book called The Boy Crisis. And it's something all about the perils facing boys on certain levels. Now, I know there's tons of perils facing girls too. But this particular book is about boys and some things that are going on in society. And we're going to be interviewing the co-authors of the book, Dr. John Gray and Dr. Warren Farrell, next week. Dr. John Gray wrote Men Are From Mars, Women Are From Venus. And you know what? I found their representatives and asked them with belief that we could do this interview. And now it's scheduled for next week. You have to just believe in yourself. There's one more story right now from my own world that I'm going to be sharing with you as I go do this interview next week, okay? And so believe in yourself and continue to study, learn, and find ways to expand that power in your world by applying and learning new principles. That's what this whole challenge number one is all about, study. Second challenge is always make great moments. Make people know that they matter. Create pillars of joy and memories in your life that even when you come to the end of your life with a few regrets here and there, these pillars of great moments with your children, with your other loved ones, family, friends, coworkers, whatever it might be, those will overshadow all that. That's what I always say. This will overshadow any regrets. We're all going to have regrets. Sorry, but we're just going to have these other pillars to overshadow them. Okay. And the last challenge is always, let's keep doing this podcast together. I love you. Appreciate you. Believe in you. And I'm flattered that you join me for these podcasts. Apply these principles, engage with us, visit us at empowerhumans.com, empower101 on Instagram and Twitter. And until next time, empower yourself, empower the world around you.
Thanks so much for listening to Empower Humans. If you enjoyed the show, please rate and review this podcast. For more great content and to stay up to date, visit empowerhumans.com. We'll catch you next time.